te Maria, Virgine, sudeo verbum et tuum angelo nunciante, carnem suscipere voluisti. Presta supplicibus tuis, ut qui veream genetricere Dei credimus, eius ab te intercessionibus adiovemus. Per eundem Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum, Filium Tuum, qui te convivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Omnipotens Deus, ut quas ei unia votiva castigant, ipsa quoque devotio sanctifice sanctarii ficet, ut terrenis affectibus mitigatis facilius celestia capiamus, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui te convivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Lectio Isaiae prophetae. In diebus illis locutus est Dominus ad casa dicens, fete tibi signum ad Domino Deo tuo in profundum inferni, sive in excelsum sopra, et dicit ac, non petam et non tentam Dominum, et dicit, audit ergo Domus David, nunc id parum vobis est, molestos esse hominibus, qui amonesti estis et Deo meo. Properoc dabit Dominus ipse vobis signum. Ecce virgo concipiet et pariet filium et vocabit nomen eius Emmanuel. Putium et mere comedet, uciat reprobare malum, et eligere bonum.
Simus aias gratiam Davidis sumis, proteria
Sancti Evangelii secundum Lucam. In illo angelus Gabriel ad eo incivitatem Galilei, cui nomen Nazaret ad virginem desponsatam viro, cui nomen erat Joseph de domo David, et nomen virginis Maria. Et ingressus angelus ad eam et dixi, Ave gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus. Quae cum audisset turbata est in sermone ius, et cogitabat qualis esset ista salutatio. Et ait angelus ei, ne timeas Maria, in venis tienim gratiam apud Deum, ecce concipies in utero, et paries filium, et vocabis nomen eius Iesum. Hic erit manius et filius altissimi vocabitur, et David in dominus Deus, sedem David patris eius, et regnavit in domo Iacob in aeternum, et regni eius non erit finis. Dixit autem Maria ad angelum, quum uno fiet istud, quoniam virum non cognoscorum. Et respondens angelus dixit ei, Spiritus Sanctus superveniet in te, et virtus altissimi obumbrabit tibi. Ideo quae et quod nascetur ex te sanctum, vocabitur filius Dei. Et ecce Elisabet coniata tua, et ipsa concepit filium in senectu te sua. Et hic mensis sextus est in me, quae vocatur sterilis, quia non erit impossibile apud Deum omne verbum. Dixit autem Maria, ecce ancilla Domini, fiat mihi secundum verbum tuum.
From the book of Isaiah. In those days the Lord spoke to Achaz, saying, Ask thee a sign of the Lord thy God, either unto the depths of hell or unto the heights above. And Achaz said, I will not ask, and I will not tempt the Lord. And he said, Hear ye therefore, O house of David, is it a small thing for you to be grievous to men, that you are grievous to my God also? Therefore the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and his name shall be called Emmanuel. He shall eat butter and honey, and that he may know to refuse the evil and to choose the good. Continuation of the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke. At that time the angel Gabriel was sent from God into a city of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel being come in said unto her, Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, who, having heard, was troubled at his saying,
and thought with herself what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said to her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found grace with God. Behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and shalt bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of David his father. And he shall reign in the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end. And Mary said to the angel, How shall this be done, because I know not man? And the angel answering said to her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Most High shall overshadow thee. And therefore also the Holy which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And behold, thy cousin Elizabeth, she also has conceived a son in her old age. And this is the 6 months with her that is called barren, because no word shall be impossible with God. And Mary said, Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it done to me according to thy word. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. So, dear faithful, we have today this feast of the Annunciation of the Blessed Virgin Mary. You heard just now in the Gospel that an angel was sent by God to a certain woman, Mary, and asked her to become the Mother of God. What is the purpose of this? It is the mystery of the Incarnation. It was needed for men, to be redeemed by the Son of God himself. No one could be made free from his sin, except if first God, except that God had to come first to save us. Since the original sin, since the first sin of man, the whole world got corrupted, the souls got changed and became inclined to evil, to bad things. And for this, God had to send someone to redeem the world for this sin. And God chose Our Lady. God chose Mary for this. And the Hebrew people had to wait many years, thousands of years, before the Redeemer come. They were waiting, they were praying, they were asking to God to send the Redeemer, but they had to wait. And it's only after, let's say, 4,000 years that finally God sent his Son to redeem humanity. And so we see in this mystery of the Incarnation, we see the beginning, that's the beginning of the redemption. The redemption is started. The Son of God comes to the world. One important truth that we can mention in this feast of the Annunciation is that if there is only one Redeemer, one true Redeemer, which is Jesus Christ, which is the Son of God, which is the Savior of the whole world, there is also someone else who is doing the work of the redemption in another way, in another level, and which is Our Lady. Our Lady is not the Redeemer, is not the one who saved us. It is Jesus who is doing this. But Our Lady, in a very special way, more than anyone else, more than all the angels, is united to the Redeemer and works with him to the work of the redemption. So that she is called by so many fathers of the Church, by so many holy people, she's called the co-Redeemer. She is doing the work with Jesus in another way. Sure, she is not the Redeemer, but she works with him. And she has the right to this title of co-Redeemer. She is doing the work with Jesus. And if there is the Redeemer, one Redeemer, if there is one special person who is also working with our Lord to the work of the redemption, it reminds us that we too, we have to be working to the work of the redemption, working to the salvation of souls. We too, all of us, we have our duty in the salvation of souls. We will not save souls by ourselves. It's not in our strength. It's not in our power. We have to. We must. It is our duty to bring the souls to God. And in this way, to help to the redemption of humanity. So this is one of these important truths that we have to remember in this feast. Jesus is the true Redeemer. Our Lady is co-Redeemer, working with our Lord to the redemption of souls. And also us, we have to unite to this work by bringing souls to God. It means being apostle. It means spreading the good word, trying to help people to come, to find out about the truth, about Jesus. That's one of our work, one of our duty. Let us remember this, dear faithful. And the other point that I would like to mention today, that is that the Holy Fathers are saying that it would not have been useful for Mary to conceive the child Jesus in her womb if first she did not have Jesus in her soul, in her heart. It would not have been useful for Our Lady to have Jesus in her womb if she was not having him in her soul. Our Lady was full of grace, was full of Jesus, full of God for all her life from the beginning. And that's why she could also receive this grace of having the child Jesus in her womb, to be so close from him. Dear faithful, during this time which are coming of lockdown, we will not receive him with his blood, with his body, with his blood, with his soul, with his divinity in the Holy Eucharist. It is going to be your sacrifice during these weeks until the Passion and until Easter. Maybe you will not be able to receive our Lord. You will not receive his body, his soul. You will not receive the Holy Eucharist. But remember that what is the most important, like for Our Lady, is not to have Jesus in our body. It is to have him in our soul. And even though we are separated for a while of the sacraments, we can still be with Jesus at all times. We can still, in our mind, be thinking about our Lord, be thinking about God, suffering for us, God giving us all the graces that we need. And so that this point that will be important also during these few weeks. You will not be able to move so much. You will not be able to be apostles outside so much. But in your family, in your home, with these people that you will see, you will have to be apostle, and for yourself then, you will have to keep Jesus present. The danger when we are at home, when we have nothing to do, no work, it is just to look at things that are not important. Let us remember that this week coming are the week of the Passion. We will have the Passion Sunday now, we will have the Palm Sunday next Sunday, we will have all the Holy Week. We will have to remember this. We will have to live with Jesus, to read the Gospel, to read the story of the Passion, and to be united in our mind with all these things that happened 2,000 years ago. We will have to be united with Jesus in his Passion. So, dear faithful, let us ask Our Lady, let us ask her to give us this grace, to give us this grace to remember that we are called to work to work with Jesus to the redemption of souls. And let us remember this, that we have to possess Jesus in our soul, to be with him in our mind, for all this time especially, that we will be separated of the sacraments that the Church wants to give us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, Amen. per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum. Pater omnipotens eterne Deus, et te in annunciatione beate Mariae semper virginis collaudare. Benedicere et predicare, quet unigenitum tuum et sancti spiritus ovum ratione et virginitatis gloria permanente lumen aeternum mundo effundi. Iesum Christum Dominum nostrum, per quem maiestatem tuam laudant angeli, adorant dominationes tremunt potestates. Celicerumque virtutes ac beata Seraphim, socia exultatione concelebrans. Cum quibus et nostras voces ut admitiu beas de precamus, confessione dicentes.
Thank you.
saecula saeculorum. Oremus. Precepti salutaribus moniti et divina institutione formati ademus dicere. Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum. Adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimite nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimitimus debitoribus nostris. Et ne nos inducas in tentationem. Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Thank you.
Patris, Omnipotens Deus et dimissis peccatis vestris, peducat vos et vitam aeternam. Indulgentiam absolutionem et remissionem peccatorum vestrorum, quibuat vobis omnipotens et misericors Dominus. Ecce agnus Dei, ecce qui tolit peccata mundi. Domine, non sum dignus ut in tre subjectum meum, sed antulic verbo et sanabitur anima mea. Domine, non sum dignus ut in tre subjectum meum, sed antulic verbo et sanabitur anima mea. Domine, non sum dignus ut in tre subjectum meum, sed antulic verbo et sanabitur anima mea. Thank you.
gratiam tuam quesumus Domine mentibus nostris infunde. Ut qui angelo annunciante Christi filii tui incarnationem coniovimus, per passionem eius et crucem ad resurrectionis gloriam perducamus. Per iundem Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Oremus. Sacramenta quae sumsimus Domine Deus noster, et spiritualibus nostre repleant alimentis, et corporalibus tuerantur auxilis. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.